What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back. And today we will discuss those two people, two persons who you should never let go from your life. Yes, yes, yes. Everybody and anybody. But these two, never ever. All right. If you're new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you are interested in having a consultation from me, then approach me in my website below. And before beginning, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Okay, so who are those two people who we should never let go in our life? Oh my God, I know. One is our husband or our wife, and the other is, I don't know who. No, they do not fall in this category. That doesn't mean you should go and throw them out of your life. No, it doesn't mean that. What I mean to say is, whatever happens, these two will always stay in your life as your well wishes. Always, irrespective of anything, unless the situation is very bad or you have yourself spoiled the situation. All right, so who is the first one? Let's start. Father, mother, grandfather, uncle, aunt. No, the topmost, the first personality that we should never ever ever let go from our life is God, right? No, it is that person who takes us to God. That personality who in the scriptures is known as Guru. The word Guru has many meanings. The word Guru, one of the meanings is he's very heavy. He or she, anybody. Heavy means one who gives heavy instructions that lifts the burden of sins from our life. Guru is one who takes us to the Supreme, to the Almighty, to God Himself. So we should never ever ever do things which displeases our Guru Maharaj. If we do that, our life will be in total ruins. Even if we get married to the best person, the most handsome prince available, or the most beautiful girl available, or we become the richest man, but in the eyes of God, we are worse than paupers. We are worst of the criminals. Because we have disrespected His representative. Guru is the representative of God. So Guru's position is unique. That is beyond anybody. It doesn't matter you are single, you are married, or you are in a corporate, or you are a politician, or you are a government official. You stay in India or anywhere. The Guru's position is unique. Nobody can surpass Him. Alright. So Guru's association should never be given up. We should always find newer and newer opportunities to go and meet the Guru. And not only go and meet Him just superficially, as in India they keep saying, Guruji Pranam. This Guruji Pranam is not going to do anything. Yes? Should I repeat? Guruji Pranam. Showering fake praises to the Guru, that is not going to get you anywhere. Yes? Then what will get us close to God? When we follow the instructions which the Guru has given us. Well, but for that there's a prerequisite. You have to select a Guru who is worthy, right? One who knows what is there in the scriptures. Only that person is authorized to be a Guru. He not only knows the theory, he also knows the essence of the scriptures. What the totality of the scriptures, what it means. Not all the verses. Yes, and he also knows who is the Supreme, God Himself. And he should be realized in the conclusion of the scriptures. And he should be a perfect, perfect doesn't mean 100%, but he should be a perfect practitioner. Yes, he may not be a perfected soul, but he should be a perfect practitioner at least. Perfect doesn't mean 100% perfect, but he should be a good practitioner in good standing. Only that person is qualified to be called as a Guru. Well, I have made a video in my channel, How to Choose a Guru. If you type it, maybe you find it there in my channel somewhere. So you can watch that. So Guru is the one, as I always say in my Bhagavad Gita classes, that Om Agyan Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Nama. Oh, my dear spiritual master, the blindness caused by the darkness of ignorance. My God. Om Agyan Timir Andhasya. Jnana Anjana means you have applied the ointment of Jnana, knowledge, Anjana, Shalakaya, in my eyes. Chakshur Unmilitam Yena. My eyes have been illuminated by wisdom. Tasmai Shri Guruve Nama. Unto that Guru I go and bow my head. My mind, body and soul is all yours. So whatever the Guru says has to be done at once, without any hindrance, without any hesitation. Yes, provided he is at that level to give us that guidance. So to the degree we are connected to the Guru by his words, not by physical proximity. Oh, Guruji has come now. Let's take a selfie. Guruji, one selfie, please. Okay. And then you go and upload it in Instagram. Yes. Yes, met my Guru today after 5 months. Yes. And then maybe if the Guru is like you, then he will also tell, oh, send it to me, I'll also share. Alright, so the thing is, not just physically associating with the Guru, trying to take his or her orders as one's life and soul. Whoever the Guru is, whatever the Guru is telling, that which helps us to go close to God, that when we take those orders as our life and soul, then we reach God. Yes, that is guaranteed. Because as they say, when the student is ready, the master shall appear. Should I repeat? When the student is ready, the master shall appear. And in the scriptures, it is said that by the mercy of God, one gets a guru. And by the mercy of the guru, you get God. So Guru and God are in one line, they are in that same structure. So to the degree you are obedient to your Guru, to the degree you follow what he says, to that degree you will be achieving spiritual perfection. So thinking to stay away from the Guru or his words or his actions is the last thing we should be doing in this life, alright? So Guru is the first person who we should never let go. We should always hang on to him or her. We should always try to be near him physically, mentally. Even if he's not there physically, mentally we should meditate on what the Guru said. That do this, do that, then our life will improve. That will give us the highest level of auspiciousness, which nobody can bestow us. Yes. Then, who is the second person who we should not let go of? Yes, you are right. You got it right this time. It is the person who gave you birth. Because if this person would have not given birth to you, you would have not got a chance to meet the Guru. Yes? So, mother is the one who has brought us to this universe. So we should never do things which displeases our mother. Although sometimes we might have to do certain things to bring her health into control, to stop her from doing some wrong activities which they keep doing. Like my mother, she keeps eating too many sweets sometimes. So I have to call her and give her a good scolding. Then otherwise she doesn't listen because she's having diabetes and I'm concerned about that. Rising blood sugar levels. I'm seriously worried. And she's aging also. She's in her 50s now, the later part of 50. So, as a son, that is my duty to take care of her. That's different. But apart from her well-being, I should not speak or do things which will displease her. Because if I do that, then the universe will not be pleased. The universe will tell me that, oh, look at this rascal. He is displeasing the person who brought him to this universe. Yes. So we should never do things that our mother don't like. Although sometimes in rare cases there can be exceptions. Like many times people tell me that I have started pursuing this spiritual path and my mother is not conducive. My mother is not supportive. Then what should we do? Even then, you should not criticize her. You should not insult her. You should not denigrate her. Just because you are doing some so-called spiritual practice, even if that is bona fide, that doesn't mean you have become superior to her. Yes. Yes, you are doing your spiritual practices. That's perfect. Yeah, sometimes, unfortunately, some mothers, they don't understand. Somebody is doing some spiritual practice, then they may obstruct. Even that's very true in case of my mother also. She doesn't appreciate me doing some particular practices spiritually. She says, just be like a normal human being. Why have to do all this? Not just be like, have fun. But she doesn't understand. I am having all the fun in the universe, right? So whenever there are some areas where there is a contradiction between us and our mother, then we should try to keep it till there. We should not try to bring that every day and try to insult her or scold her or try to prove her that we are superior to her. We should never do that. And apart from that, we should always be respectful, kind, considerate towards our mother, because I have seen, as I have lived in this short span of 25 years, I have seen relatives leaving me and leaving others. I have an elder brother, but I'm not sure he will always be there for me. I have my father also. I'm still not sure if he will also stand by my side always. But there are two personalities I know that will always stand by my side. Yes, that is my Guru Maharaj, and so many gurus I have. And then the other is my mother. Okay, so these two assets we should never lose. Never lose these two assets. And if there is a conflict between both, suppose your guru is telling one thing and your mother is telling something else, then at least we can talk with the guru and try to handle the situation and come to a consensus, because sometimes the mother may not understand, because she may not have that level of a maturity which a guru has. So then we might have to temporarily take some decisions which is not conducive for our spiritual path, for time being, for temporary relief. That doesn't mean you, if your mother says, oh, why have you given up this eating meat? From tomorrow you start eating meat. No, that doesn't mean we follow that. Fate doesn't mean blind faith. Oh, whatever mother is telling now, we will just do. Tomorrow she tells us, go and eat meat, we'll eat that also. No, that's not correct. Even my mother keeps telling me, why don't you eat meat? There's nothing in vegetarian food. She thinks like that. But that doesn't mean, just because I am obedient son to her, so-called obedient son, that I go and start eating meat again, which I had left 8 years back. No, that's stupidity. But that doesn't mean I go and insult her also, right? That is another extreme, alright? So, wish you all the very best in dealing with these two personalities, and I hope that you come to a consensus. Sometimes if there is a disagreement, and if both of them are in the same page, then, well, very good, you are blessed. Unfortunately, not many people are blessed like you, maybe. Okay, so if you can, then try to please both of them, and by that God will be very happy. All right, until next time, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website below. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with others. And if you want me to make any other video, then let me know in the comments. Okay, until next time, wish you good luck with your guru and your mother. Okay, until next time, bye bye, see you. We'll be right back.